All right, boys and girls, today I'm going to talk to you about a story that's from the book called Where the Mountain Meets the Moon. And the story I'm going to be telling you is the story of Fruitless Mountain. Fruitless Mountain is a humongous mountain. And it was back in the days when there were no rivers on the ground. This mountain was so tall that it went all the way up to the sky. Sky high, you may even say, to the clouds, into the clouds, all the way up to where the clouds were and the birds were.
What?
And Fruitless Mountain, as I said, takes place in a time when there was no rivers in this area. So just grass. This is where our story begins, boys and girls, at Fruitless Mountain. If you follow Fruitless Mountain all the way up into the sky, you're gonna find Jade Dragon. Jade Dragon had an amazing power, an awesome power. What she was able to do was control the clouds. She would push the clouds away to make sure that the sun could come in. And she would also push the clouds in to make sure that there was enough rain for the people in the village below. She had so much pride and joy in the powers that she had. She really enjoyed the fact that the people below looked at her with so much respect. They were happy to have her. Jade Dragon, as you can see, wasn't the only one in the sky. She had four children. Their names were Long Dragon, Pearl Dragon, Yellow Dragon, and Black Dragon. She took great pride in having her children up in the sky with her. And she was very happy because not only were they big and strong dragons, they were also very helpful. They would help their mother when she was in the sky, controlling the clouds, blowing them away. So one day, Jade Dragon was busy blowing the clouds away and letting the sun shine through. She overheard a conversation between two of the village people below. Now, one village person she overheard started speaking and said, "Man, I am so happy that those clouds are finally gone and there isn't going to be any more rain." She was happy that the rain was gone. Jade Dragon kept listening and heard the other townsperson say, "I know what you mean. I couldn't stand all that rain. I hope it doesn't come back for a long time." Well, Jade Dragon got so angry. She was very upset. She was so upset at the village people. She started to say stuff to herself. She said, "So, you don't want the clouds anymore? You always want the sun?" "I'll show them," she said. "I'll keep the sun there forever." Initially, that may sound good. Sunshiny days, beautiful. Well, as those clouds went away, and the sun started to beam down on the people in the village, they started to recognize something. That sun was blazing hot, and it shined down day after day. Jade Dragon wasn't going to bring those clouds back. The people in the village started to get a little nervous, because when they looked around them at the plants and the animals, they started to wither up and die. Well, the people in the village started to think, if that's what's happening to the plants and animals, then we better watch out. We could be next. We need water. There hasn't been rain in days. What are we going to do? So they went to Jade Dragon and they begged and they pleaded. And they said, "Jade Dragon, please, please, we need the rain. Bring back the clouds." Jade Dragon just looked away and ignored them. She wasn't going to bring back the clouds. However, the people in the village, their complaints, they weren't going unnoticed. Jade Dragon's children started to notice, and they knew they had to do something. They asked their mother, please bring back the clouds. She wouldn't do it. So they said to themselves, we need to come up with something. They met away from their mother, high in the clouds. They said, we don't know what to do. The one said, well, I don't want to be disobedient to Jade Dragon, our mother, but we can't let the people of the village die. What should we do? And just like that, boys and girls, Long Dragon came up with a brilliant idea. He said, I know what to do. I'm going to go down all the way to the land, and I'm going to sacrifice myself. And when I go down, I'm going to lay down and turn into a river. Now the three brothers and sisters looked at Long Dragon and said, are you crazy? They were astonished and shocked. But when they started to think about it, they realized they needed to do it. So one by one, each of the dragons went all the way down to the land of the village, laid down and sacrificed their lives, and turned into the rivers, the four great rivers of this land. Now remember, there were no rivers at that time. So the people were extremely excited. And the sacrifice from the four dragons saved the town. They turned into those four rivers. That brings us back to Jade Dragon. When she found out what her children did, she was heartbroken, so upset. She didn't know what to do. She cursed herself for her pride, for not listening to the people of the village. So upset, she fell all the way down out of the sky to the bottom of Fruitless Mountain. And she wanted to transform herself as well. So she transformed into the biggest river of them all, which is known as Jade River. She was hoping to one day reconcile with her children. Well, boys and girls, as you can see, we're back at the Fruitless Mountain. And they say that when Jade Dragon's heart broke, it was her broken heart that became Fruitless Mountain. It sat there, and it will sit there. It's dark, it's hard, and it is lifeless. And it will remain that way until, they say, when Jade Dragon finally gets reconnected with at least one of her children. And that, boys and girls, is the story of the Fruitless Mountain.